just want to tell you what I think about you. Yeah. Yeah. I just want to tell you what I think about you. Jesus. The last beginning and the end. In you I live and move and have my being. You hold my life, my world, my future, all in your hand. And you knew my name before time began. Woo! There's absolutely nothing you can't do. And absolutely nothing compares to you.
Good morning, DU. How's everybody? Okay. That's what I'm talking about. I'm glad everybody's good. You know, we're staring a holiday in the face, Thanksgiving. I just want to know, what are y'all doing? Eat. Besides eating. What you doing, Jay? What y'all got playing? At the crib. Crib, now y'all got family out of town or anything? Maybe. What you doing, Janae? Staying home. Everybody staying home? You going to fit? I understand. Facts. Well, we're hitting the road. We're just doing a simple trip. East Texas, Texarkana, Kilgore, just seeing family. But what I want you, just always stay thankful. Always stay thankful. God has given us a ton of things, and he continues to give us a ton of things. But, oh, yeah, online people. Happy Thanksgiving, and I know this is after Thanksgiving that you're going to see this, but hope you had a good Thanksgiving. But always be thankful, y'all, because there are a lot, and y'all have heard this for years, there's people that don't have half of what we have. I mean, sometimes we can look around and they're like, oh, man, I ain't got this, I ain't got that. But there are some people who are literally drinking water out of puddles, for real. And we used to say back in the day, think about the children in Africa. You know, they ain't got this and that. But think about the children right here in the U.S. that don't have anything, and they're drinking out of puddles, and they don't have any running water in their house. And so they got to get water out of and I know this because I've heard this, get water out of a faucet outside, pour it in the toilet so you can flush the toilet. So don't think, you know, every once in a while that you don't, as a matter of fact, don't think that y'all don't have friends that are struggling. I'm not saying that they're struggling to that extent. But don't think that y'all don't have friends that are struggling. Today's topic, I want y'all to keep something close to your heart. So today's topic is about the past. Let me ask y'all. I'm going to ask two or three. Define past, like past. Kira. Something that's already happened. Cool. Kiana, define past. You need some more time to think? Keelan, define past. Something that happened before, something that already happened. Come on now. It's not something that's not happening in the now. Okay, come on. Wow. Something that you can't redo. So the definition I looked up, having existed or taken place in a period before the present, kind of like what you said, but something that happened in the past. So I want y'all to just think, We're going to do a quick exercise. So on your piece of paper, I'm sure you got a pen and a note card. And I don't want y'all to share these with anybody online. If you have a piece of paper, just get a pen real quick. So on that piece of paper, you know, because we've been talking about sex and dating and things like that. So on your piece of paper, write a word that reflects a sin or mistake in the area of dating, relationships, something from your past that you can't seem to move beyond. And you know, for, you know, some of y'all might not be dating. So let's just say something from your past that you just can't move past, something that seems to have you kind of stuck. So just write it down, something that has you kind of stuck. And it doesn't even have to be anything serious. You could just be thinking about, man, I shouldn't have looked at my friend in school like that sideways or something. Just write it down. Just write it down. Just think. I'm going to give you about a couple of minutes. Just think about that thing and write it down. Go ahead, Kiev and Kira. Go ahead and write that thing down. And just, you know, don't show anybody. I don't want you to show anybody. So write that thing down. Just think about it. Something that you may have done. And you're just not able to move past it for some reason. And that little thing kind of has you stuck. I'll give you about another 30 seconds. And then we will move on. And when you've written it down, go ahead and just fold it up, put it in your pocket. But just don't, you know, don't show anybody. Now if y'all want to share what it is later, that's totally on you. But this is a thing that's between you and Jesus. So just kind of tuck that away. And then I'm going to ask a couple of questions. And I'm going to give y'all a second to ponder it, because I'm going to come to Melody. So just be prepared. I'm going to come to Maya. I'm going to come to Chase. So when it comes to the past, why is it sometimes really tough to let go of that past thing, some things that happened to us or things that we've done? Why is it hard to let go of those things? Come on, Melody. Why is it hard to let go of stuff?
It's hard to let go of stuff because you don't know somebody's reaction.
Mm. Come on, then.
And for say if I was going to lie, because I don't know what the reaction is going to be, and then you turn out to find that they weren't going to have a bad reaction to it, and you can't go back.
Can't undo it. Come on now. Good. I like that. Mike? Why is it hard to let go of some stuff?
I think like sometimes bad memories can come back and it's like memories come back and it just feels like you can't
remember. Mm. Come on now. That's good. Kira, come to the other Kira first and then we'll go to Chase. Because I like the way she was nodding her head. That's good. Okay. Now we're going to go to Chase. I like y'all answers because sometimes even in our adult lives, you know, we do stuff and sometimes it's just hard to move past those things. Guilt sticks with you. Guilt. And we're going to kind of address that in a minute. So I like that guilt sticks with you. So what are some of the ways that a person's past might define or limit their future? And I'm asking that question, but going by what y'all said, you know, the guilt, you know, if that thing is kind of holding you down, you know, Janae, you could have did something and it just keeps messing with you and you just can't get past it. You're constantly, man, if I hadn't have done that, this wouldn't have happened. And that type of stuff happens all the time, all the time. We wish we would have done something this way or that way, but we can't get past it. The scripture, y'all open your Bibles. The scripture is Philippians 3, 12 through 16. Philippians 3, 12 through 16. And this is a popular scripture. I'm going to give y'all a second to get to it. This is a popular scripture. I'm sure y'all have heard this one in the past. But Philippians 3, 12 through 16 says, I don't mean to say that I have already achieve these things or that I have already reached perfection, but I press on to possess that perfection for which Christ Jesus first possessed me. No, dear brothers and sisters, I have not achieved it. Now, this is Paul talking about, even though Paul was powerful, he's saying he still haven't achieved it. So that's music to my ears. I know that. So no, dear brothers and sisters, I have not achieved it. But I focus on one thing, and this is what he says. Forgetting the past and looking forward to what lies ahead. Forgetting the past and looking forward to what lies ahead, because there's always something better ahead. I press on to reach the end of the race and receive the heavenly prize for which God, through Christ Jesus, is calling us. Let all who are spiritually mature agree on these things. If you disagree on some point, I believe God will make it plain to you. But we must hold on to the progress we have already made. Paul says, I press on to reach the end of the race. And here's just a fact. And I got this from Enduring Word. It says, we often let those things which are behind distract us. As an adult, y'all, I'm not going to lie. As an adult, knocking on 50, my daughter's always messing with me about that too, but knocking on 50, there's been some things in my past, I ain't going to even lie, because I jacked up some stuff. Straight jacked up some stuff, Jaden. I mean, bad. Had folks looking at me sideways, crazy. I've jacked up some real stuff, and I have even, on occasion, just let that stuff just constantly beat me. As a matter of fact, there's one thing I kind of still hold on to this day that happened about 25 years ago. It still kind of eats at me. Happened about 25 years ago. Y'all ain't even close to 25 yet, but it happened about 25 years ago. Still kind of eats at me. You know, I prayed about it, you know, tried to move past, but that thing every once in a while, it creeps back in. Creeps back in, and I'm just like, God, man, why did I do that? Why did I do that? I'm living healthy, glory to God, but why did I do that one thing? 25 years ago, about 25 years ago. But we move on. But it says, we often let those things which are behind distract us, whether they be good things or bad things. Looking at what is in the past often keeps us from what God has for us in the future. Now, Kira, is that thing that I did in the past keeping me from what God has for me? What you think? I don't think. I don't think. But why do I keep looking at it, Cam? Why do I keep looking at that thing I did about 25 years ago? It eats at us. So sometimes things will eat at us. You know, as far as the ability to forget, you know, I don't, you know, and what Paul is saying, you know, forgetting the things behind me, you know, we don't have that capacity to just forget a lot of things. But he's talking about, you know, I'm not going to worry about that type of forgetting that. You know, I ain't going to worry about that because that happened in the past. And he's saying, I got to go forward. So as a matter of fact, Kira, on those two long pieces of paper, do me a favor. Right there. Write on one of them, write in big letters, write God's best. And I should have did this. Write God's best in prayer. And on the other piece of paper, just write P-A-S-T, the past. Come on, Jaden, come on up. You're going to be, what grade are you in, Jaden? You singing? You hooping? You know what? But Jaden's going to be, all right, Eric, you hold the past. You hold the past, and go stand over there, back over there. And Hunter, you hold God's best over here. Let me get hold God's best, and just stand where you are. So this is how the past, you know, kind of affects us. So everybody stand up real quick. Everybody stand up real quick, and go to your debt. Go come right here in front right now. Come right here in front. All right, now Jaden. So what I want you to do is just look at God's best. And, you know, just act like you're going towards it. Just act like, you know, do a little, you know, like you can move smooth. Like, I'm going towards God's best. Go, and then somebody calls you from your past. Turn around. Look at your past. So just go slow. Go back toward it. Now, go. Just keep looking at your past. Keep looking at your past. Now, turn back around. And where is God's best? You kind of got distracted, didn't you? you kind of start looking at your past, and it's not that God's best is not there anymore, but you went back looking at your past, and now all of these things are kind of clouding your vision because you were focusing on your past. And that's how it happens sometimes, because God's best is over here, but we're constantly, come on, let's do it again. God's best is over here. Come on, God's best. You're doing a good job, God's best. So almost get to God's best this time. Move slow. Move slow. Call out, Pastor. Say, come on, Jaden. Yeah. Jaden walking back to his past. He almost reached his past. Now turn back around. God can say, come on, Jaden, you can do it. So God's best is calling you, and now call out past. Come on, move toward God's best again. Now call out again, past. Boom, that's it. Small illustration. Thank y'all. That's how quick it can happen. That is literally how quick we can be moving towards, constantly moving. You can just ball it up. We constantly be moving towards what God has for us, his best. But that past thing just keeps calling out. That's why Paul said, he said, I press, because we stop focusing on God's best. Whether the things are good or bad, sometimes we can't get past how we did something so good. Let me say that again. Sometimes we can't get past how we did something so good, it's all we talk about. Because if we did something so good, that's all we're going to talk about. Period, right? If it's so good, we're going to be like, yeah, I did that thing. You see me, I dunked on him. I can't dunk on nobody, but I dunked on him. So that's all we're going to talk about. But then sometimes we can't get past how we did something so bad, it's all we think about. So if it's so good, that's all we're going to talk about. But if it's so bad, it's all we're going to think about. We're going to ruminate on those things, Kiana. Y'all know what ruminate means? Ruminate means constantly thinking about something. Whether it's good or bad, you're going to constantly ruminate on that bad thing or good thing. And it doesn't, let me just be clear, it doesn't have to be a bad thing. You can constantly ruminate on a good thing. But if you constantly ruminate and constantly think about that good thing, it's all right, think about it. But what about what else you could be doing good if you just constantly think about that one thing, if you're hanging your hat on that one good thing? Oh, I did something good. You're talking about it for 5 years. I did that once. I did. So sometimes we can't get past how we did something so good, it's all we talk about. Sometimes we can't get how we did something so bad, it's all we think about. As a matter of fact, and we think about distractions. And this is just an example for me, distractions. So I started taking notes for this on Wednesday. Saturday morning, I said, okay, let me go ahead and finish up. So I'm on my computer. On my laptop at the house, just typing, but football happened to come on. So football's on, I'm just, okay, going, okay, let me, oh man, that was good. I'm going, so for a while there, I was like, man, boy, this is a good game. And so I'm going back and forth, not really, but just being distracted like a mug. Okay, let me click save. Apparently I didn't click save, lost over half my notes. Talking about a brother having to restart because I got distracted. And for a while there, later on in the day, I was hanging on to it, the past. And that was keeping me, my vision, and just thinking about what notes I'm going to take and what resources I'm going to go to. I couldn't think about the future because I was thinking about the past so much. It can be small. It can be something so small. But really, like Paul says, you have to press on. Does your past define you, Harold? Harold said, you kind of, sort of? Okay. Harley, does your past define you? Okay. So Harold said, counter, sort of. Does your past define you, Kiana? Wait, Kira, yeah, thank you. Because she got that soft voice.
I think, like, the things you do, like you've done things in your past, but also the things you did.
So they don't make you who you are. Even though you did them, but they don't make you who you are. I like that. Eric, what do you think? Does your past define you?
No, I don't think your past defines you. I think I think what you choose to do now in the present and in the future, that
come on now. Come on now. Okay. Somebody over here. Macy. I'm sorry, Kira. Macy, does your past, things you did in the past, define you? Hey, come on, go deeper. Okay, you said no. Okay. All right. Does your past define you?
So when your past kind of helps you, it makes you who you are now. Therefore, if someone does define you, because if that hadn't happened, then you probably wouldn't be who you are now.
Come on now. Okay. So let me ask y'all this, this statement, you know, is it true that once a blank, always a blank? Come on. You can't? Okay. Can some once a blank, always a blank? Do y'all believe that? So why not? Well, anything. Anything. That's why I just said blank. See, I see you in your mind. Okay. See, that's why I just said blank. Once a blank. I mean, you can say once a thug, always a thug.
Well, no, I don't think that's true. Like I said, we're constantly changing. So, like, if I stole in third grade or something like that, that doesn't mean now.
Once a thief, always a thief?
Yeah, I don't believe in that. Because, like, you're changing. And then God forgives us for the things we do.
Okay.
All those years, are you really letting go of the past and keeping it
covered? Label. I feel you on that. And what were you going to say in a female perspective?
Just the same thing that people change.
Yeah.
And, I don't think once of this, always of that. Because we all go through different stages of our lives.
That's right. That's good. I feel you in that. What you think, Jay?
I think someone can, like, remain in that label a long time. Some people,
that's a fact.
They take until they die to actually have that thought process. Like, I should have done this.
Come on. I feel you on that. Labels. And people can carry a label. We'll get to Cam. Thank you. Thank y'all.
I think that if, like, say you stole something, like, then people will view you from the outside as a thief. So
yep.
They don't trust you. But, like, you might have a change. You know, so you're not a thief no more. But people will always view you as a thief.
And so thank you. Thank y'all. So it is our job to not let those once a thug, always a thug, once a thief, always a thief, just carry us. That's not what God's about. God's trying to get you to that next level, that next dimension. But if we keep harboring on the fact that we were a thug back in the day, and, you know, I said this before, people are going to label you no matter what. You're going to have a label, you know, oh, she thinks she good because she got on this sweater. She always thinks she all that because she got on this sweater. And he think he all right because he always got on J's. He ain't nothing but a little old whatever. So people are gonna, you don't worry about that because people are gonna slap a label on you anyway. I know I probably got about 80,000 labels. It's okay. But we can't let whatever we did in the past and past things hold us back from our future. Kira, can you key up that video for me? And I'm glad y'all said this because I want y'all to watch this video real quick. And this is called Redeemed. And we're talking about, and I'm going to get off out of the way of the camera. And let's think about being redeemed and not being labeled and being able to do something else.
I grew up seeing people sell drugs and seeing people use drugs, but got to this point where, you know, my older brothers and my friends were selling drugs, and you know, that was the way that we paid the rent, you know, and so I got introduced to selling drugs at a very early age. I started getting arrogant, you know, feeling like no, I'd never get caught. But the crazy thing was, everybody that I ever saw sell drugs before, they all got caught. But I figured I was this, you know, special drug dealer that, you know, it would never happen to me. And it was at the end of my ninth grade year that was, that's where my life really started to take this turn. You know, I had met this teacher who was involved in this church here in Austin, and she was going on a mission trip and then came back the next year. She showed us this video that she recorded, and man, displayed how people with next to nothing found joy in Christ. There was a young man on there, a young Kenyan man, and he said, you know, hey, we love y'all, we would love for y'all to come visit us here. So that's what she wanted us to see, but the invitation that we saw, we jumped on it and said, hey, we want to go. So we started doing these meetings every Wednesday night. I saw God working in my life the whole time as we were prepping for the trip. But I just had this doubt in the back of my mind that says, God, I know where I come from. I know what I do. And I know where I'm going to have to go back to when I come from this mission trip. Same prostitutes out there selling their bodies. Same guys out there selling the same drugs. I sold drugs the moment before I left for the mission trip and, you know, sold them as soon as I got back. So about 2 days later, when I got back, you know, from a mission trip, I got caught selling crack to an undercover police officer, and it was at that point where I was like, okay, God, like, I'm at rock bottom. There's nothing that I can do. Like, I need you to intervene. Like, I remember going and telling the teacher what happened, and I remember her just, like, breaking down and crying and feel like she failed. The community that came around me during that time and was like, okay, you made a mistake, but just as you see it, we see God is calling you to something. You know, for me, that's not what I'm used to. I'm used to, you know, you made the choice, so therefore you have to deal with the consequences on your own. And I've heard the gospel preached, you know, many times, but the thing that was different in this situation was I was seeing the gospel lived out. I was seeing people literally be the hands and feet of Jesus. And at this point, I have a decision to make, like, am I going to keep running with the world and the things that the world tell me to run after, or am I going to run to, you know, what I know is, you know, true, and that's, you know, Jesus did die for my sins. You know, he did, you know, leave heaven and come to the ghetto. That's what he did, you know, and so at that point, you know, it was just a decision that I had to make, and, you know, a decision that, you know, I made, and, you know, community came around me and, you know, supported me in that decision and showed me, like, you know, what does it mean to be a follower of Christ? I've been redeemed, not just for the sake of being redeemed, but to redeem those around me, to redeem the people that I come in contact with, the people that knew me, you know, before, you know, I accepted Christ. Like, those are the people who knew me at my lowest and darkest point. God has given me a mission. He's placed me in the neighborhood. He's placed me in, you know, for a reason, and we're called to make disciples, and so that's what I hope to do in my city.
Amen. Amen. So what y'all think? I mean, point blank, old boy, he's not being defined by his past. He was selling crack. Selling crack, selling drugs, all of that. He was in the streets. He was in them streets for real and got caught. But now apparently it sounds like he's back in the same neighborhood. And so we talk about labels. He's back in the same one of the same neighborhoods. So he's probably got folks looking at him. Oh, look at him. He was selling drugs. He's this or that. He's this or that. But that young man is pressing. That's why Paul says, you know, I press. Because when you press, you have resistance. You got a lot of resistance, but you got to press. You got to keep going forward because that past is going to call you. The past calls us sometimes like a past whisperer. Hey, so-and-so, come on back. Because a lot of times that past, let's just be honest. A lot of times in the past, we had a good time. But that doesn't mean we cannot have a good time in the future. So we got to focus on the future and keep aiming towards what God has for us. Because if that man focused on the past, he wouldn't be doing what he's doing right now. That's why Paul uses I press. So here's the reality, and we're going to come to a close. Many of us have made a lot of mistakes in the past, whether it's dating, relationships, or whatever. And the thing about it is, some of y'all know folks who are doing stuff that they should not be doing. Guaranteed. Some of y'all know some folks, and some of y'all, I hope it's not y'all, but some of y'all know some folks who are already doing certain things that they shouldn't be doing at a certain age. Some of y'all know them. Like I said, prayerfully y'all not, but some of y'all know them. Some of y'all know folks who are in them streets hard, probably doing a little selling on the side. Some of y'all know them. Absolutely. And those people that y'all know, they're getting a label. But here it is. But because they know y'all, y'all have the opportunity to speak to them. Y'all have the opportunity to say, hey, you know, hey, Cam, you know, you don't really need to be doing this. Let me take you over here and show you the direction you need to go. And Cam can get out of that life. Pray you never go to that life. But Cam can get out of that life. And all of a sudden, Cam's a new creature and he's pressing. He's going forward for what God has for him. He's going towards the prize. But he's going to have that label. But it's up to Cam not to let that past define his future. That's the kicker. Do not let your past define your future. A lot of people have, and a lot of people have had not such a good life because they've let their past define their future. When you let your past define your future, you're going down a path of destruction. Always go forward to what God has for you. So remember that piece of paper y'all wrote on earlier? Y'all got it? So what? Let me ask you this. How many people actually wrote something on that thing? That you, raise your hands high. Okay. Kim, give me a trash can real quick. Y'all go ahead and bow your heads. Just bow your heads real quick. This is between you and God. Think about that thing that you wrote on that piece of paper. Just for about 20 seconds. Think about the thing you wrote on that paper. About 20 seconds. Now say a short prayer to God. Ask God to let you, allow you to let go of that thing and not let that thing that's in the past define your future. I'm going to give you about 10 more seconds. It's between you and Jesus. Now what I want y'all to do, in Jesus' name, amen. Now what I want y'all to do is rip up them things. Rip them up, because that thing took place in the past. You're not going to let it define your future. You're going to be able to press forward and move on, because you're going to go towards the prize that God has for you. Amen? Go toward the prize that God has for you, and Kiev, and throw it in the trash can, because Kiev is going to come around with a trash can. That thing is done in Jesus' name. Now, yeah, oh, I hear that, Kier. Now, you are in a position to press. Now you're in a position to press on. Y'all repeat after me. I'm in position to press. I'm in position to press. I'm in position to press. In Jesus' name. Thank y'all. Y'all give God a hand praise. Let's move. We're going to move away from the past, online people. I pray in Jesus' name that you were able to write something down and you were able to just rip that thing up, because your past, once again, does not define your future. And remember, you are in a position to press. Amen.